Hi guys, and welcome back to another Photoshop tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how you can create a transparent PNG using Photoshop. And I'm going to start right now. Right guys, so the first thing you want to do is go ahead and choose a photo. And if you'd like to follow along with the same photo that I'm going to be using, just go ahead to the link in the description. And today I'm going to be using this photo, which I got from unsplash.com. So what we want to do is we want to create a cutout, remove the background, but then save it as two different formats. So we're going to save it either as a PNG, which is kind of like a universal format that has an alpha channel enabled. Alpha channel basically means it has a transparency to it. JPEGs, for instance, just work on three channels, where PNGs work on four channels: red, green, blue, and alpha. Alpha is the most important thing, because that allows you to save photos as transparent. And then we're going to save it as a PSD, which is a Photoshop format, which again has that alpha channel enabled, but obviously it's a slightly larger file because it isn't as compressed as a PNG. So what we're going to do is we're going to firstly create a cutout. Now, multiple ways of creating cutouts, but the quickest way is simply using the quick selection tool, and then we're just going to refine the edge using the refine edge brush tool. So once we've got our photo open, we're going to go over to the left hand side. We're going to go and find the quick selection tool, which is roughly at the top left corner. Now, it might also be called the object selection if you've got a new to Photoshop, or it might be the magic wand tool. But if you click and hold, you'll see the quick selection tool is in the sub menu here. Now, the quick selection tool is very similar to the brush tool. What it does is it selects areas that you brush over using high contrast edges. So for instance, if we click and hold, it will select that gray area or that shirt area because it's a very similar color. And if we hover over the white area, as you can see, it's now selected larger areas. So what you need to do is just go over areas that you want to actually keep. So we're gonna go ahead and select all of the hair. We're gonna select the ear, and we're gonna select around the edges. Very nice. So once you're happy with the selection, again, if you make any mistake, all you'll need to do is hold down the Option or Alt key on a Mac, and then you can remove certain areas, which makes it a lot easier. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna go ahead and open up the Select and Mask Options tool. So we're gonna go to the very top hand corner, and right next to Select Subject, you've got Select and Mask. We'll go ahead and click it like so. And you'll open up with this extra menu. This is allow us to kind of customize our mask. So when we cut it out, we're just removing any area that is selected in green. So we can see we're going to be removing the background. So at the moment, the background is in green. Now you can change that color if you want. Over on the right-hand side, you can choose your color. So for instance, I've chosen green because it's good contrast against this blue. But for instance, if you wanted to, you could choose a red, you could choose a blue, for instance, but I'm just going to be keeping it as green for this instance. Lovely. But as you can see, if we go ahead and zoom in, especially around the hair, you can see we've got this kind of blue area coming through, and the cutout doesn't look that good at the moment. So what we can do is actually use the Refine Hair Brush tool to actually remove any areas that aren't quite right at the moment. So on the left-hand side, we've got a bunch of tools. The one right at the top is just called the Selection tool, and that's the one that we used to actually use before we went ahead and actually opened up the Select and Mask. But the one below it is called the Refine Edge Brush tool. And this will actually refine any areas. So the way to use it, again, very similar to the quick selection tool, is just simply click, hold, and what it'll do is Photoshop will re-look over any area that you have highlighted. So as you can see, we've got this blue bits coming through the hair here. If we click and hold, what we can do is actually remove certain parts of that blue, and but still keeping the hair. And it works really nicely on high contrast edges, or any edges that have a large difference in color. So as you can see, the sky is predominantly blue and the hair is predominantly quite dark. So as you can see, it's working quite nicely. Now, if you go to any areas that are not that, so for instance, colors that are very similar, this particular effect might not necessarily work too perfect. But again, it is worth trying just to see. So what you just need to do is just go around the edges here until you are happy with the result. So we'll go ahead all the way around. Again, the more time you spend on this particular part of the process, the better the outcome will be. So we're gonna go ahead and we're just gonna go ahead, select down here. And then once you've done that side, we're gonna go ahead and do the other side as well. Again, you can change the brush size by using the bracket tools on your keyboard. So the right bracket makes it larger and the left bracket makes it smaller. And then you can change the size depending on the area that you're selecting. So we've just done the beard there. As you can see, that's worked quite nicely. So we'll go up, do the eyelashes and the eyebrow. And then we're gonna go up and just do the last part of the forehead. Again, if you make any mistakes, you can reverse this particular technique because we're adding in at the moment. You can reverse it by pressing Alt or Option on your Mac, and you can actually reverse this process. And again, if you make any mistakes, you can always go back to the selection tool on the left-hand side tools panel, and you can revert back to it. But at the moment, for this particular tutorial, I am quite happy with the results. So once you've done that, on the right-hand side, you've got a few other options. So you can add a slight feather, you can smooth the edge. So I'm gonna smooth it by 5 pixels, and I'm going to feather it by 1 pixel. I always recommend adding in a slight feather because it makes the process look a lot more realistic, especially in the end result. And once you're happy with that, we're gonna go down to our output settings. Now at the moment, our output is selection, which means when we output it, it's not going to do anything to the photo. So we have an option of either creating a layer mask to that layer that we're just working on. But what I like to do is add new layer with layer mask. So it means we're always working on a different layer, which means if we ever make any mistake later on, we can always revert back to the original layer. It's a good way of working non-destructively in Photoshop. And then we've got that new layer with layer mask activated. But again, if you are just you working on one layer, you could just choose layer mask if you want. And once you've done that, we're gonna go ahead and click the OK button. And what that'll do is it will open it back up into Photoshop. Now, at the moment, you can see we've got these kind of gray, white and gray squares in the background. That is our alpha channel. So that is our invisibility or transparency. If we go ahead and save it now as a JPEG, all of that area will turn white. But if we go ahead and save it as a PSD or a PNG, what that will do is that will keep it transparent. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go up to File. We're gonna go down to Save As. And if we go ahead and save it as a PSD first, so that is a Photoshop file, it will allow us to keep that transparency. So as you can see, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna save it to my desktop, and I'm just going to call this PSD test. And then we're gonna save that as our format here as Photoshop. So we're gonna go ahead and save it like so. The reason I like saving Photoshop files is it saves all of the layers information. So you can always go back and open up your photo to where you last left off. If you save it as a JPEG, a TIFF, or anything like that, it will compress all of those layers into a single layer, and you'll lose all of your layer information. Then what we're gonna do now is save it as a PNG. And what that'll do is it'll remove the layers, but again, it will still keep its transparency. So what I'm gonna do is gonna go to File, I'm gonna go to Save, Save As, and then I'm going to drop down using the format drop-down window, PNG. And I'm gonna go ahead and call this a PNG test. Lovely, and I'll go ahead and click Save. Now I'll open up with a PNG format. I always recommend largest file because it's the fastest way of saving. And as you can see, we've got our saving icon in the bottom left-hand corner, just telling us it's saved. So we go ahead and minus that, we've got our two tests here. So we've got our PSD. As you can see, all of that area, gray area, is all transparent. And we've also got our PNG. And as you can see, again, very similar, it is all transparent. So that is the main difference between a PNG and a TIFF. If I go ahead and save it, for instance, as a JPEG, so I'll go ahead and save that, and I'll just call this a JPEG test. What I can do is I will show you what is different. So this is a JPEG, and as you can see, all of that area has been turned to white because again, it doesn't have that alpha channel. And if we do a PNG, as you can see, that area is now completely transparent. And that is how you can save your photos as a transparent file, either using a PNG or a PSD.